Good morning children. Now next class we are going to start about the water energy. We know that Earth's surface is covered by 71% of water, and these water resources also can be utilized to generate the electricity. So harnessing of energy or producing the energy from the flowing water can be used to produce electricity. And the technique by which we can harness the water energy to generate the electricity is called hydropower. So definition we have to discuss, we have to study the technique to harness or to harvest the water energy is called hydropower. The electrical energy is derived from water flow, water falling from a height. Hilly areas are suitable for this purpose, where the water will be falling by force, and that force can be utilized to generate the electricity. It does not cause any environmental pollution or waste generation. That is the advantage of water energy. The next word, hydropower plants, which converts the kinetic energy of flowing water into electricity. This is also called hydroelectricity. Now next part we are going to discuss about the tidal energy. Tidal energy is nothing but the energy obtained from the movement of water due to ocean tides. Tides are the rise and fall of sea levels caused by the combined effect of gravitational force exerted on the ocean of the earth. A tidal stream is nothing but the continuous waves, number of waves can be utilized to generate the electricity. Tidal stream is the first flowing body of water created by tides. Turbines are placed in tidal streams. When the tides hit the turbine rotates and converts the tidal energy into electrical energy. What are the advantages? That is the important thing of all the non-conventional resources of energy. What are the advantages? Tidal energy does not produce any pollution. That is common for all types of non-conventional resources of energy. They are not at all generating any type of pollutants to the environment. That means pollution free. Common points we can write for all these four types. It does not use any fuel, so that does not produce any waste. That means pollutants will be not produced. Number three, tides are predictable. It is continuously tides are going on, so that we can use that this one as a resource to generate the electricity. Tides are predictable, so tidal energy can be produced at any time, continuous source. Water is denser than air, therefore can generate the electricity at lower speeds than the wind turbines. These are the advantages we can get from tidal energy. Now next part we are going to discuss about the rainwater harvesting, which is very, very important. It is a common process, everybody knows little bit. Now next part, what do we mean by rainwater harvesting? It is a technique of collecting and storing the rainwater for future use. It is a traditional method of storing rainwater in underground tanks or in ponds or in lakes, check dams, and that water can be utilized for future use. The main purpose of rainwater harvesting is to make the rainwater percolate. Percolate means it goes under the water, under the earth's surface, to recharge the groundwater level. Under the ground, so as to recharge the groundwater level. So we will be not suffering from water scarcity. What are the different methods by which we can harvest the rainwater? First method is called the rooftop rainwater harvesting. Rooftops are excellent rain catchers. They can catch the maximum amount of rainwater. The rainwater that falls on the roof of the homes, apartments, commercial buildings is collected and stored in the surface tank, and that can be used for domestic purpose. That is called the rooftop rain water harvesting. Second method, it is called the recharge pit. In this method, the rainwater is first collected from the rooftops or open spaces and is directed into the percolation pit. Pit is nothing but a small hole. With that hole, the rainwater to be collected from the rooftops and catchment area or open space and to be sent to those pits through pipes or for filtration. After filtration, the rainwater enters into the recharge pits or ground wells. Now, village people, what they are doing? People living in the rural areas adopt a variety of water collecting methods to capture and store as rainwater. Some of the methods are, first one, digging of tanks or lakes. These are in Tamil, it is called the eries. It is one of the traditional water harvesting system in Tamil Nadu. Eries are constructed in such a way that if the water in one area overflows, it automatically gets diverted to the area of the nearby next village, as these eries are interconnected. So it is the best way to harvest the rainwater in the rural areas. Number two, uranis. These are the small ponds to collect rainwater. The water is used for various domestic purposes, maybe drinking, washing or bathing. These ponds cater means supply or provide the water the nearby villages. What are the advantages then? Rainwater harvesting helps to overcome the rapid depletion of groundwater levels. As we are recharging the groundwater level can be maintained by rainwater harvesting. So that is the first advantage. Second one, to meet the increased demand of water, we can fulfill the requirement or the demand of water used by the human being. Number three, reduces flood and soil erosion. The excess amount of water if we hold, that is causing the flood. So the flood situation also can be reduced and soil erosion also can be reduced. Fourth point, water stored in ground is not contaminated by human and animal wastes. Hence, so that water can be utilized for drinking purposes. So these are the advantages, 4 marks question. Now next, electrical energy and management. Electricity or electric power is produced by generators. The generators are operated by turbines attached to it. The turbines are rotated by maybe steam, maybe moving water or by wind power to produce the electricity. So electricity can be produced by different methods, maybe by conventional methods, maybe by using the non-conventional sources of energy. Conventional sources of energy such as coal, by burning the coal it can boil the water, that means steam also can be produced. Here the coal is utilized to generate the electricity, moving water, which is called the water energy, wind power, which is called the wind energy. These are the different methods or ways to produce the electricity. Conservation of electrical energy. The following measures can be taken even at home and school to save the electricity. What are the different methods by which we can save the electricity? Use energy efficient appliances to save the electricity, like CFL, generally we will be saying that one, compact fluorescent lamps, light emitting diode, that is LED bulb, and other electric equipments. These lamps or bulbs are having more brightness, but they will be consuming less electricity. In that way, these appliances are considered as the energy efficient, consuming less electricity, but the purpose will be solved. Number two, switch off the lights and fans, televisions and other electrical appliances when not in use. In that way, you can save the electricity. Switch off the mobile phone chargers when not in use. Number four, maximize the use of solar radiation. Solar water heating system can be used instead of electric geysers, so that electricity can be saved. And the last point, minimize the use of air conditioners. So these are the different ways we can save the electricity. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स।